Peter Dutton, we mentioned Tanya Plibersek likened him to Voldemort. Jane Caro also jumped into the fray because the left, once they've got a gag, they kind of stick to it and they all repeat it, even that, when it wasn't funny the first time. What did you make of that, Rita, the Dutton-Voldemort thing?
Well, you know what? If Tanya Plibersek not only called him Voldemort and had a go at his physical appearance, something he has no control over. He can't control being bald. So it's not a choice he makes. Then she also advised him to smile more. Now, can you just imagine the unbridled outrage if... if Peter Dutton had told Tanya Plibersek, you know, you should smile more and I'm just going to have a critique of your appearance while I'm at it. So the double standards are what are glaring to me, but I thought he played
he
it really
it well.
Well.
James,
he handled it well.
Look, I think Peter Dutton handled it very, very classily and, you know, I heard him on Ray Hadley. He was talking about this and, you know, he was absolutely fine about it because politics is a rough and tumble business. Sure. I mean, you know, let's go back to the era of Paul Keating. You know, there used to be some fantastic sledges, a lot more witty than Voldemort, for that matter. But I do think, though, that if this government, and to his credit, Albanese did smack down Tanya Plibersek for this pretty quickly, but if they are going to come in on this whole sort of ticket of niceness and kindness and we're not being mean to everybody. Well, the thing that the right always needs to do with these things is the first rule of Saul Alinsky's Rules for Radicals, which is what the left has always followed, which is hold your opponents to the standards they set for you.
Exactly.
And, you know, in doing so, you know, they should absolutely insist on them being as absolutely woke, nice, kind, touchy-feely, non-insulting as possible every minute of the day. It will drive the left nuts.
Well,